All right, everybody, welcome back to the laboratory. I'm going to walk you through a little bit of this and see how far we get. Just some preliminary things about this. The thinner you cut the tape, the better the chances at attaining curves and stuff like that. So you can do all kinds of neat stuff. Again, I'm not going to go all the way out. I'm just going to show you the first few stages of this so that you get an idea. The pattern and design is up to you. Again, I would use references. The other thing that I use is I keep a little handy scrap journal around where I write the stages and the steps for a paint job, you know, so that you know exactly what goes on first and stuff like that, because this requires a lot of masking. I mean, I'm talking about you'll spend easily lots of hours on a paint job like this, because you have to go laying down the tape, painting, laying down more tape, painting. So you're building up layers depending how many colors you want. So anyway, I started here with just simply finding, I don't know where I'm going with this. It's a new, I don't know, it's going to be a different design every time it is. So you better get it right. Now the taping, you could, you know, you can remove, you can move around, and then you can, just like they do in the real vehicles, you just, you know, bring it to the edge, make sure that everything is, you know, smooth. You come over here to the edge where, again, this is where the glass comes in, and with a little knife or with tweezers, okay, you just lift. Again, if you have fingernails, hey, you're lucky you. So, you know, you just handle the tape, make sure that it doesn't curly cue up on you and stick to itself. Again, you want to cut them thin as is humanly possible. So, you know, you just, again, I'm just trying this out just to show you. I hope you could see it. And, right? And then you could just with, again, it's very easy. You go finding, once you see, I missed a little tip there, so it's not a big deal. Okay, it would be if I think you're using a softer type of paint like enamel and you didn't let it cure, you're going to be in trouble. So you want to make sure your tape is layered correctly and that there are no gaps, and you press with your fingertips. And again, try to follow the same curves, the same spacing. All right, it's a design that, you know, you wanna. Does that look right? I keep looking at the computer. See, it's looking a little bit off, in part because I left a lot of space up here. So it's a matter of just taking it easy and having fun. You don't want to rush this. Okay. The reason why I'm splitting it down the center like this is because then you're able to copy the design on the opposite side. All right. So you can do all kinds of different things with this. And you're going to also start noticing that because I didn't use a pencil to scribe my lines on the tape, it was very hard for me to cut. So you're going to see right away the difference in tape widths. Okay. And so let's see what we got here. This might be a little bit tough. Again, it's, the idea is just to be playing with this stuff. All right. So you anchor down, make sure that everything's square, and then using your finger and your hand, you pivot the tape around a curve, all right? And it'll follow you. It won't be a problem, okay? So, okay, I hope the design is starting to come through, all right? So, I don't know, it's looking like a bird, but that's the beauty of, I mean, the art form of lowriders and lowrider paint jobs is that. It's just these guys who are insane about getting a beautiful design. It always reminds me of Art Deco for some reason. But, you know, this could be addictive too. I don't do it so often because it requires, again, a lot of time. And I'm usually, you know, tempted to just bring out the templates and go crazy with the templates. But this has its payoffs. You begin to see, once again, as I was saying, the different thicknesses of the tape. And the problem is that I didn't cut use the pencil to make sure every line was just right. So let's see, what else are we going to do with this? I don't know. You could sometimes go like this and, you know, keep a fairly even, like that. See? So you go, you know, you go laying it out like this. Okay. So the first order of business after you get it all done, right? So you put your coat of paint, whatever the next, so the gold is already, the gold is going to be the design color. Right? If you want other colors, then you have to start coming in with maybe a bit of more tape that you cut, and then you cover these spots. Let's say I want it, let me get this without scratching. Let's say I wanted this to be red and this blue. Well, then you start masking accordingly and you spray your paint. So it's a process of taping and painting, taping and painting. And it's a process that's beautifully made for airbrushing. I do not think you're going to get good results with multiple colors using rattle can. Maybe you can, okay? But, you know, maybe if you're using two to three colors, it'll work. But you need to be able to just, if you're going to do that kind of layering, put the tape, the paint down thin. You're also getting a lot of mileage out of fogging the edges. There are all kinds of stuff. For example, I could do the whole layout and then come in with a doily and put it right over and then spray the doily design. And when you remove this, the gold will come through and the doily pattern will be in another color. I hope some of that is clear. If you want to see a professional doing it with model cars, check out Zed Customs. Okay, I'll provide you the link for his YouTube so that you could Facebook, so that you could see exactly the madness. I mean, he's absolutely brilliant when it comes to these paint jobs, and again, they require time. So put the time in and just have fun. Get your glass, as I said in the previous video, your mask, hobby mask paper, and just go crazy. You could do circles. You could do all kinds of neat patterns. For example, you could take a hole puncher. Let me see if this works. I dreamt about this last night, believe it or not. I'm thinking, maybe I wonder if you could use a hole puncher. Get a, you know, from the office supply, and just you know, punch some holes, okay, on your tape, and then come in and again, this is a reason why, see, suddenly now you've got some more interesting stuff going on. So you can vary it up. There's no rules to this. There are no right or wrong. It's up to you and what you want to design and what you'll like. I can do this with templates a lot faster than spending the time going, you know, taping. But, you know, taping and templates are not the same thing. They require different kinds of preparations and things like that. So, but in conjunction, they would work great. Like I told you, a doily is a template, and you bring one of those lace doilies on here, and you'll do a pattern like that. You've seen it, I'm sure, on a lot of low riders and a lot of custom paint jobs. So these are just basic steps. I just wanted to walk you through them. So I hope you enjoyed it, and stay tuned in. I'm going to keep going on this, and next time you see it, it'll be probably completely different. All right? So I just wanted to walk you through the simplicity of masking and how much fun it could be. Make sure you use a pencil and scribe your lines so that you could see them as you cut them, so that you can really guarantee the same thinness in the tape. And you can go as thin as you want, as your eyes, you know, use a magnifying glass use a magnifying glass, and it'll help you out. Anyway, thanks for tuning in. Dr. Kranke wishes you well.